Well, welcome everybody. We're doing another highlight of an event going on in the tech community here in Las Vegas. Tonight I've got Darius with me. He's the founder.
Co-organizer
of the Las Vegas Robotics Meetup. So tell us about the robotics meetup and why you got it started and what we're trying to do here tonight.
Well, Bob and I shared a vision, and over many beers, we took the challenge upon ourselves to try and organize the robotics community in Las Vegas.
Okay.
Robotics is just at a dynamic time. I'm a degenerate startup guy. I moved to Silicon Valley after college. I went to China to see what the startup scene was there. I've started several of my own startups. And robotics is just in the air. You can tell that this is the next wave that's coming. And we see all of the robotics people in Las Vegas, and it just wasn't connected. And so that's why we started talking to some of the local robotics companies, like Palolu, which is where we are here today.
They're our host tonight, which is amazing. Thank you, Palolu, for hosting us tonight.
And it's such an amazing company, and so many of the people that should be using their equipment to build robots did not even know about them. And so if we're going to, I don't think it's a competitive dynamic, like there's going to be inventions that happen across the United States, but Las Vegas itself is 60 to 70% automatable.
Absolutely,
so
yeah.
We are the epicenter. So we need to know how our roboticists here in Las Vegas can build into that surf that wave.
Yeah, it sounds like the robotics community here is much larger than until tonight I even had any idea. Did you find the same thing? I felt the same way about kind of the startup community, the tech community here in general. Is there's a lot of folks doing their own thing, and it's really hard to get them together to kind of talk about things, collaborate, and build a community. Did you find the same thing when you arrived?
Las Vegas is such a brand spanking new city that it's hard to know where to convene. So there is a downtown, and that is where the tech community has traditionally been. But all the cheap real estate is south of the airport, and that's where all the robotics companies are. Mm-hmm. And just in general, there's been an emphasis until ChatGPT, and we can get back to that, but
Absolutely.
There's been an emphasis until ChatGPT on software as a service startups. So how can you scale quickly and make apps for the hospitality industry? How can you help people get hotels better? Robotics was definitely not seen as the focus of Las Vegas, but that's all changing now that suddenly robots can be smart, smart enough that they can start to serve you drinks. And there's actually a lot of other activities such as defense work here in Las Vegas. And of course, they're not allowed to socialize as much.
I was part of that community when I was on active duty in the Air Force, so I know what that's like.
Yes. I think that there is a sea change happening that will bring robotics into the mainstream, and we just need to aim ahead of the puck.
Okay. So what about ChatGPT and generative AI is driving the train here on putting robotics to the forefront of the community?
I mean, when the big problem with robotics has been putting robots in for the domain of hospitality is putting robots near other people. Mm-hmm. So if a robot can trip someone or trip onto someone, there's this danger level, and it's the common sense aspect of it that ChatGPT suddenly brings into the fold. Suddenly, without training a robot specifically to do that, we have large multimodal models. Mm-hmm. And the robot can sort of learn common sense ways to avoid people. And that's what's making the difference.
We can use AI to tell a robot, hey, just be cool.
Yes.
And then the robot
just
can go
be cool.
The robot can go figure out what it means to be cool. You don't have to program every little action for the robot.
Jason, that's the meetup's new motto. Just be cool.
Just be cool. It's been my motto for a long time, but I'm glad I could help.
Well, the thing that I really want to stress is that we're not just a meetup group. Mm-hmm. So we are aiming for larger things in the community, and the meetup group is the first step towards that.
Okay.
And towards that, we're creating a directory so that all of the robotics people can talk to each other and find each other. And it's a karma-based meetup group. So we want you to ask for help and give help, and hopefully in equal measure. So, and building on that, we're hoping that we can introduce entrepreneurialism into that and ask for connections so that we can bring this community to the attention of Silicon Valley and show them, hey, this is the perfect place. Even though you might have funded a startup in California, where do you really want to do a pilot project? Absolutely. Las Vegas.
Where does everybody want to do everything?
Exactly.
Las Vegas. Well, I hope we can help you with that. I'm part of an organization called Vets in Tech, looking to help veterans get into the tech world somehow, whether that's through finding a job, whether that's through education or through entrepreneurship. And I think Bob and I are going to talk a little bit about that tonight, about, because I know you guys have, in addition to the directory, in addition to getting people to ask for help and provide help, you have some other things, a bigger vision. And I don't know if you want to get into that here, if you'd rather Bob get into that.
Or... I'll let Bob explain some of the different options.
I would love to hear Bob's take, because Bob goes back way back with the founder of Vets in Tech, Catherine Webster, as well. So what else? What else should we know about the meetup tonight? We're going for probably another 45 minutes or so, I'd say. If you're in Las Vegas and you're watching and you're interested in robotics, come on down. How often do you do this meetup?
Once a month.
And does it move around? Is it always here?
We've got a few staples. So some regular places. Palolu obviously has been a great supporter of ours.
And yeah, they've been fantastic tonight.
Such an amazing space. So and it's for anyone out there watching. They manufacture in the U.S. So I should let Jan give his own interview, because he's going
to
tell you so much more. But
I
worry that he's not
going to
tell you how amazing it is that they've been manufacturing in the U.S. for 20 years where nobody else has made it work.
Well, I would love to talk to him. If he's got some time, please send him in, and we'll put him on the stream tonight to shout out Palolu, because I'm just learning about it over the last couple of days, and it's super exciting. So
absolutely.
All right. Anything else you want us to know about the meetup or the robotics community in general? Any big things coming up for you in the next couple of weeks?
Well, I have my own startup, and so it's an exciting time to be in solar energy.
Yes.
So I'm making solar panels that work with each other and have an intelligence built into it. And so it's a different type of robot, and we're also supporting some other robotics efforts. But that's the other thing that's always on my mind is, where can I do pilot projects for innovative solar?
Awesome. Well, I hope those solar panels are going to just be cool.
Absolutely.
And
yes, Jason.
And thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for letting us be part of your meetup tonight. This is always fun for us to come and sit down and talk with the people who are coming to these meetups and get their stories. So if you would, when you walk back into the main room there, send us Bob or somebody cool to talk to.
I will.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Nice to meet you,
Jason.
Great to
see you again.
Nice to see you again, Jason.
Yeah. All right. Cool. All right.